You know, this is a real fun decision. I have to decide whether to eat a boxcar Willie or a Belgium Giant. Let's take a close-up look and see what they look like. You know, the Belgium Giant has nice stripes going up and down. But look at this. It has a little bit of cracking going on over here. And I think it's because I forgot to water them the other day, but a little crack in a tomato doesn't bother me. Up from that one is the big cat-faced one. I have one cat face, and it's really not that bad. But what's really nice about it is the striping. I guess that's going to be what they all look like, striped. And it's a big one, too. So that's a Belgium Giant. And then down here is Boxcar Willie. They're smaller tomatoes, round, good shape, beautiful color. One's almost ripe here. These two, I believe, are ready to go. If I'm going to pick one, it's going to be this one. And you know what? I think that's the one. Now, when I pick a tomato, I don't just yank it off of the vine. Right at the top, you'll see that there's like a knuckle. If you push your finger on the knuckle and then bend it against the knuckle, it snaps right off. It's perfect. Doesn't break anything. That is actually a beauty. Minimal cracking, just a little at the top, which means nothing. No cat facing whatsoever. Is that a beautiful, perfect tomato or what? I like the look of this. This is boxcar. Let's slice into it. Inside is perfectly ripe. Let me smell it. Oh, wow. That is a good smell. That is a nice, fresh tomato smell. Good look on the inside. This is Boxcar Willie. The inside has a nice amount of meat. It doesn't have like large sections of goo. It just has them kind of spaced out like this snake going around it. And that's actually not bad. Let me taste it. Okay. Oh. Oh. Okay, pardon me while I run around the yard a little bit. Okay, I'm happy with this tomato. And Boxcar Willie has a nice, soft flesh, not too grainy, and you know, some tomatoes will have that graininess to it. No, not so with this. It definitely has the homegrown tomato taste, the old-fashioned tomato flavor that your grandma probably remembers, but we haven't seen in the stores in like 100 years. This has a good homemade flavor. It has nice skin, nice, soft skin, not too thick. You know, some tomatoes may have a real hard skin. This is very easy to slice into. A lot of juice, but not too much. Not too much goo, and that's what I like about it. This is the good part. The center part, that's the best part. Nice. I'm going to have to give this one top marks. Definitely. I'm going to definitely grow this one again, and I'm going to recommend Boxcar Willie. I couldn't help myself. After slicing into that Boxcar Willie and taking a taste, I ran outside and I grabbed another one. This is not Boxcar Willie. This is the Belgium Giant, the one with the slice on the side, you know, the crack. And I figured, what the heck, I might as well eat this one too. I'm going to eat the whole thing later, but I wanted to taste test them side by side. And the thing about the cracking, if you want to keep the cracking down on your tomatoes, keep the watering even. This potted tomato is really hard for me to keep up on because it is so big, it has such big tomatoes. It actually has one of them that's about three times the size of this. Yeah, it's one of the ones that I'm going to enter in M.I. Gardner's tomato contest. But this one is the one that cracked the most, and it has a new crack, I just noticed. That's from uneven watering. When it gets wet, dry, the skin does not expand fast enough for the influx of water. Nothing I can do because it's really hot out there and it's hard to keep it moist all the time. But cracking doesn't bother me one single bit. I'm just concerned with the flavor. So let's slice into this. This is the Belgian. I have no idea. It's Belgium Giant. Okay. Inside. Let's take another slice off to get way in there. Wow. Take a look. What do you think? Hardly any goo. Now that shows me something, because you know me, I don't much care for the goo. I like the flesh part because that's where the flavor is, and that's the good stuff for me. That is actually really nice. Let me take a taste of this and tell you what I think. Okay. Very good. I can actually taste a difference. This has sweetness to it. A lot sweeter taste than the Boxcar Willie. Not that it's sugary sweet, it's just a sweeter taste. The other one had more of an acid taste to it, which I really like. This one has more of a sweeter taste, which I think would be perfect for sauces. And with the low goo here, I think this would make a wonderful sauce tomato. Holy Moses, if you like a nice sweet spaghetti sauce or pizza sauce, this would be the one for you. Absolutely nice. Very good. Good flavor to it. Good color. I like the striping. It's a very pretty tomato. It is a super strong plant. Produces extremely well. And if you want a big honkin' slicing tomato for your burger, this one's going to be the one, because the tomatoes that I have on there, this is a small one. This is considered small for a Belgium Giant. So if you want a big slice of tomato that covers the whole hamburger bun and hangs over, pick this one.